Today we're going to look at this. It's a DIN rail cutter from Pheonix Contact.
Can't be just called a DIN rail cutter, Gordon.
Okay, so Pheonix Contact has sent us products before to have a look at on the channel. We've looked at the crimp fox and the uni fox, okay, and they've got fox in common. So this can't be from Pheonix Contact because it doesn't have the word fox in it. So I'm going to christen it the Foxy DIN rail cutter for this video.
Oh, well, yes, okay, Gary, it is. Yeah, this is a specialist bit of kit. Now, let's remember where Pheonix Contact live. Their market is the panel builder.
It is.
And you're right, those products we've looked at before. Fantastic ferrule crimper and even a tool to pull your cable ties to the right tensile strength.
Yeah, and they were great products, and we love products on the channel that save electricians' time. So now we're going to see if this DIN rail cutter can save electricians' time. Do you agree?
We can, yeah. Let's have a look at how it works first, Gary.
Okay, let's put the DIN rail cutter to work, or as we like to call it, the Foxy DIN rail cutter.
Yeah.
Just secured it to the bench. Obviously, normally, Gordon, I think you'd have it to a metal plate or maybe a vice or a G-clamp, is that correct?
Yeah, you can do it. Yeah, lots of fixing options.
And these eyes here are really important because it's the measurement here. So that's the point at which you go for your measurements. If I wanted 100 mil, that's the position there I'd go to.
Oh, yeah. Lock it off.
Yeah.
It's got a little stop that flips up.
Okay, yeah, so we're at 100 mil. And then obviously we've got this arm that stops it from going beyond that point. So you rest your DIN rail against that for the cutting. But look how far we can go. So unscrew it. Let's have a whistle along. Look how far we can get this back out here, Gordon.
Yeah, so all the way up to a metre long DIN rail, which, yeah, I suggest that's quite a large cabinet by the time you're at that stage.
Yeah, that's a lot of ferrules. Okay, so we can set it at 100 mil. And I'm going to cut the DIN rail at that length. Huh? Precisely doing it. Okay, yeah. So we've got two different sizes of DIN rail that we're going to use. So that's the slightly larger one. And this one I'm going to start off with, Gordon.
7.5 millimetres, Gary.
Okay, thank you for the measurement. So we're going to slide it in now. So we're going to need to come around the other side in order to insert it. Okay, so there you go. So we push it through and at the stop block, that's our 100 mil measurement. Okay, once I'm comfortable with it, look at this. That's it cut. So we've got it there. Just cut it through, take it out. Just got to move that block arm, Gaz, come on. Yeah, so move that out of the way in order to retrieve it. Beautiful, nice straight, smooth cut. So let's sit from the other side now, Gordon. And we'll step up to the slightly larger stuff. Give me the mils.
That's 15 millimetres.
Thank you very much. But look at the actual machine itself. In this position, you couldn't cut it. You can notice the two blocks are not in line. The arm needs to be raised. Levels off the side blocks. And then obviously it can be inserted. I'm going to do it at 100 mil again. So there we go. So down to the 100 mil point. And again, just pull. Something quite satisfying about doing that as well.
Like pulling a pint of beer, Gary.
Yeah, remarkably like it, yeah. So let's have a look then. So we've got the ends now super smooth on those ends. Yep, no file needed. And we're ready to go. Okay, so there's a couple.
Yeah, let's just have a look at that action again. Oh, lovely.
Just get, yeah, crunch, crunch, crunch. Yeah, so in goes another one. Again, the larger stuff, 15 mil. Slide it in, bar up.
Let's have a look, here we go.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, would you ever use a hacksaw again?
It's really easy.
Wow, you made that look easy, Gary.
It was easy. That's what it looked easy.
And again, so, you know, the advantages of that, obviously, clean ends. No filing or other preparation. You don't cut your fingers on those ends. It's ready to go. Obviously, it is a specialist bit of kit. If you're a panel builder, that could be a huge time saver. Always set up and ready to go just to cut these two profiles of DIN rail.
Yeah, really good. Now, they make some other things similar to this, don't they, that cut?
Yeah, again, so they're in the, yeah, Pheonix Contact, in that panel building world. Obviously, the other, if you're using DIN rails, you're probably going to be using a lot of this, which is obviously slotted trunking. They also make a different version that's suitable for just cutting these as well.
Okay, and when we talk about this, it comes in two sections, doesn't it? You can just buy the cutting mechanism, and then you can add the rule feature if you require that as well. Shall we have a look at some of these ends and see how clean the cuts were, Gordon?
Let's have a look, yeah.
Has Wonky Joe been out with his hacksaw at any point?
I think, yeah, when we did the DIN rail challenge with the Weehaw screwdriver, just check out that. But yeah, so you can see, we can see some hacksaw marks. That might not be quite as straight as it could be.
Okay, yeah.
And here's our one that's been through through the machine.
Rub your finger over it. That is, yeah, there's no preparation needed, is there?
No, so I mean, that's the end that it comes out of the box.
Right.
This is the end that's been through the cutter, so that is a nice clean edge. You can't complain about that.
So more time saving for no filing required, almost. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, does exactly what it says it's going to do. It cuts DIN rail, whether it be 7mm or 15mm. Have I got that right?
That's it,
yeah. You always like to correct me if I haven't. And it just works right out of the box, doesn't it? Bang, 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 off you go. And it's the panel builder's world we looked at today, not necessarily your day-to-day job in Spark. However, we'd still like your comments. Please leave those below. Is this a tool that you'd idolise and would like to own? Is it a tool that you currently use and you've got some other great features you want to share with the community? Maybe something we haven't mentioned, Gordon, yet?
Yeah. Or is there another specialist tool that you're using, whether you're a panel builder or perhaps you work in some other field that you think everyone else would benefit from taking a look at?
Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.